Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Trailmaker. This is week two of the ESL tournament, a cash money tournament being put on by UGen Systems in sponsorship with ESL. And we have, actually, I think it's Focus from Interactive. Before we get into it, special shout out though to BPT. They fielded something like three teams, and two of their teams are actually in the third place runoff. And we're in the quarterfinals and the semifinals, so they did very, very well. WTF also did very well. They got one of their teams into the finals. Their name is WTF in Space, represented by Hunter Skydrake. Trademark. And their opponents, representing the color red, also packed. Two pack players here, pack teams. We have PLF, and they will be represented by ElBubba and the Monkey King. All right, the Monkey King. So there's a lot of teams signed up for the tournament, tons of teams. BVT, as I said, did very, very well. The entire team did. WTF, I think they fielded, I'm not sure if it was three or four teams. Two of those teams did phenomenally. And I think this is PLF's second team. I think they have two teams total. So they all did very, very well. And, you know, it wasn't an easy tournament. Once again, the Tiga Firestarter team just got launched out of the tournament midway through. And, you know, there's Anoka, Dirty D, Rebar, all these guys in the tournament. And these are the ones that hit to our finals. And so we're going to see Highway to Oslo. And this is, of course, one of the classic European escalation maps, one of the simplest ones that are out there. And it's also one of the brutal ones. It's brutal because it's very linear. Very, very linear. There are actually not too many attack paths. You will be seeing a lot of just in between these two zones. More than likely, we will not see a creep into this area here. This is very unlikely. But we could possibly see a creep through these woods into this area. That's absolutely possible. We will probably more than likely see a fight through the middle here to try and get to these juicy middle bases. We probably will also see a fight later on in the game on this flank here. It's a little bit weird because there are these ridges here, and these ridges do cause problems for attacks and defenses, specifically because you have to crawl up into this area here, at which point there could be AT firing from this direction, or AT, in fact, in this little building here. So lots of stoppages on getting things going. Of course, the standard opener right now is pretty air heavy. Now, of course, neither player is NATO, so neither player will have an entirely massive air force, and we're more likely than anything just to see Yaks. And of course, since this is Highway to Oslo, it means that, yes, Skydrake TM isn't in fact correct. This location here is going to be very vulnerable. It is a crossroads that goes in the two directions. If he can get a napalm or a cluster bomb off on this location, either or will do. And the same is true right here, this little crossroad. A napalm here, it's absolutely brutal. So both forces, both sides will have to do some pretty insane amounts of counter napalm. That would be your air superiority fighters and your radar based types. Now we have a match beginning. We're seeing some forces moving on here. Of course, Wargame Airline Battles has its absolutely realistic graphics. You will see crazy stuff like a command leading the charge here. Absolutely. And now we're moving on. What kind of air jet fighters do we have coming out here? We have three MiGs actually coming out here from our red team, the PLF players. But unfortunately, there's also three MiGs greeting them, and a little bit of a trade-off here. One MiG does go down. Will he be able to spin in this air micro battle? There's a fourth MiG being deployed, and there's three Yaks on the field. There's one Yak coming from ElBubba. Now, of course, mass Yak here doesn't pay off too much, just because there's not too many roads here compared to other maps that we usually see this kind of thing on. The one Yak will, in fact, get cleaned up, and looks like Red also did not get their payload off, so neither player able to get their... Actually, never mind. Here comes one Yak. One Yak does, in fact, survive. Looks like it got its payload off and does, in fact, have some fire going to land on this location. Get some pretty good stuns here and should slow down the forces from grabbing this two-point base. Of course, by slowing it down here, this also means they will not be able to push up into here and into the Delta base. All the while, we see a nice follow-up here from our... WTF in Space players, as they have some helicopters here going to land into these towns and try and secure forward. As well, we see that they have the BTR-60 PB going to rush ahead forward, and P PLF, of course, is going to try and move up with a nice amount of infantry of their own. Looks like they're going to get shot down, however, by some helicopter action here, as Conquerors are being deployed. Not really going to be particularly useful, but they also will not die. Probably going to stage right in this little town here, as there's not a ton of AA on the map. Just actually, I changed my mind. There's actually two OSAs and a Tunguska absolutely crushing on the AA. Shouldn't see too big of an air problem here. VDVs will secure this base as Spetsnaz will be trying to move in to create a nice recon position. If the Spetsnaz can spot, and they do, it looks like all forces will be firing, including the Spetsnaz, which I'm not entirely sure I agree with, but we'll see how this goes as the T-80U is giving insanely high amounts of support along with these two BTR-60 PBs. The VDV squads should in fact be cleaned up relatively fast. We're at zero leaking here. Both players have filled their drains, and looks like the VDV squad will go down. The Spetsnaz squad will try moving in into this position, and this will give him a nice armored position to be from, and as well a nice place for him to scout. There is a single behind the lines infantry here that was able to creep just a little bit too far, and there's more VDV squads here on the red side this time, and there's a few motostrelkies, but probably not enough to actually clean all these up. Might be able to get the two, but no, stun was pretty fast, and down he is out. There's tanks moving up the support here from Monkey King, and looks like the forward position is still very much contested. If he can clean up the Conquerors and these two BTR-60 PBs, he'll be fine, but no, here we go. We have some anti-infantry vehicles with some AT support coming in. The Tunguska will supply the anti-air, as there's tons of helicopters in the region for him to pick off. He does, and they will continue moving up with a T-80U in tow. However, the amount of forces here from our red team, from the PLF, is just ridiculous, and they will try and destroy as many of these tank destroyers, as many of these AT, as much of this anti-infantry as humanly possible. We see a huge move up here, 60... The 60 PBs are moving up into VDVs, and no go. The Conquerors, however, will looks like they'll get picked off by VDVs as well. In some more of these really unusual, not necessarily good engagements, the Conquerors, of course, are providing vision for the T-80Us, and looks like this is a pretty massive stalemate so far. There will be another vehicle coming up, possibly with more VDVs on this other flank here. And keep in mind, only two flanks right now. It's still very much a stalemate, still much a battle for this middle. 264 is going to move up in here and try and do some damage, but oh my god, it's completely exposed. T-64s along with Conquerors firing on it. It's got to pull back faster, faster, faster. Is it moving backwards? It is good. And it will in fact get out of there just in time. Only had 5 hit points left, and honestly, if some of those rockets would have connected, it would have been a completely different story. Now the Conquerors, it's over here, completely out of rockets, and looks like the rocket will fizzle out and hit nothing. Yes, almost hit the Strela here, but a lot of these Saklos, they're called, are really funny. Once they lose their target, they just fizzle and hit almost anything they can. Speaking of which, one PTRS Conquerors here will in fact probably get picked off by T-64. This could be a possibility of pushing out with some more AT. We'll need, yes, here comes another group of AT. We'll try to push them forward. The Conquerors are completely out of rockets, and the default command was to move forward, and they sacrificed themselves, unfortunately. T-64, brilliant play there, able to get a pretty nice hit. And no, this is a different variant of this one. This is a BVI, this is a BMI, or BM. Yes, and that gives it the Cobra rocket, which gives it a distinct advantage in these kind of battles here, as T-64 is going to get brushed off pretty easily. There are some Conquerors here to support, adding a little more rocket damage, but they are looking to get picked off pretty easily. Yes, the T-64s only need one more shot, and they will clean up that group of Conquerors. And as well, there's a random shot here from Conquerors. I'm not entirely sure what they're targeting here, what they see. Looks like it's a TO-55 and an OSA. He does, in fact, get the OSA, so that's pretty huge. The less AA, the better it is going to be for Blue. Of course, they went with a very, very heavy airplane opener, and they definitely don't want to pay for that. This Delta flank is starting to look a little redder, but as you can see, this is not been closed exactly. They haven't been able to secure too many towns, but they will be getting some AT into this town, which will be huge. 50 modal strel keys will be deployed, and that should be more than enough to actually take it to town. AT is actually getting picked off by T-80U. T-80U, of course, very heavily armored, very mobile, has insanely high range, and is overwhelmingly the best tank in the entire game. And if I could say, it is the most beautiful piece of machinery I have ever seen. Absolutely beautiful food. Speaking of which, battle in the middle. Looks like we're seeing a little bit of change here. Some napalm getting dropped. Should be able to push these Spetsnaz out of the way. And the VDV squad could also die, which would be pretty big. There are some conquerors here and a little bit of helicopter support. Of course, these are the transport helicopters, and anytime you can use a transport to get some pretty serious kills is pretty serious business. There's actually a TO-55 in here, which of course does have its own napalm ability, can napalm the area if it wants to, and might get picked off here. There's three BMP-1Ds, of course, have that tank destroyer weapon on it that can try and push this back. The TO-55 should try to at least get some napalm on this area before it runs away, because this is actually a very strong position for this TO-55 to be placed in. Helicopter trying to pick off what he can, as I said. This time he's going for these BMP-1Ds. And if he could just napalm this road here, that would be awesome. But looks like I'm going to go ahead and use the tank destroyer variant instead on it. Of course, it does have a tank destroyer weapon. It is a tank. And the smoke is really good here. Actually able to completely clear that area. Needs to get some napalm happening here, ever, or this TO-55 will be completely useless. Actually getting a little bit too close. BMP-1Ds continue to move forward. Wants to kill his BMPT desperately. And this TO-55 looks like it might get sacrificed instead of doing the killer damage it can do. BMPT. Oh, here we go. Finally. This is going to be big. 50% of this town has been covered with napalm. And not doing nearly as much damage as I thought it would. He's going to charge up and try and do a different napalm on a different section and maybe do some more damage. For now, it looks like we're seeing a pretty strong stalemate. Of course, slight, ever so slight advantage going to go to the red PLF players as they were able to get a point slightly faster. As these motostrelkies are absolutely not melting. They are in the fire and they're just eating it and surviving. Now they are panicking. They should start taking damage relatively soon, or else this will be ridiculous. There might be a need for some bold moves soon. And yeah, here we go. Actually, red is able to actually push forward. Ooh, almost vomited. That would have been disgusting on the air. Red can actually take this base now. He can absolutely put a command right here, and it should be pretty well secure. There is a red Adventicus here, but he doesn't know about that. Or does he? Looks like a 60 PB is going to try and duke with it, but there is actually some AT in the distance, and BMP-3 is able to knock that out. And still a great forward position here. Great opportunity for PLF to capitalize on this by bringing a command here. But looks like none. Oh, here we go. A T-72 command. This is our tank command. This is our frontline warrior. And of course, he can actually join the fight as well. He's also insanely armored compared to every other command. Just, what, 11? Now, of course, this is the less popular of the tank commands for PAC. Most PAC, in fact, enjoy the T-80 command, which is a little on the overpowered side. A lot of people are throwing away games by actually using it as an official vehicle to be used in battles, and that's just really not what it is. Pretty good smoke here, by the way. Smoke blocking the vision of these conquerors so they can get some of these vehicles out of this position here. Very, very good. And very excited for the T-72's arrival. Where are you at, buddy? There he is. And, yes. Now, of course, there is some sneakiness on this map. This is not a map that's completely devoid of sneakiness, but they've kind of prepared for it. It's such a narrow map that's hard to get away with this. Now, this Spetsnaz can actually sneak past this helicopter. That would be absolutely huge. There, of course, is nothing protecting this. Now, when you're kind of doing this sort of move, you have to realize your opponent can also do that sort of move. So PLF is very, very well prepared. And as this motostrelky and this helicopter, oh my god, insta-dead. They've prepared for it, though. They have a few infantry here and some AA ready to support in case there is some kind of crazy maneuver here. And it's these little moves that are very cheap. This is a really long invested, but it's also very cheap. You're looking at a 30 point infantry to try and take out a command. It also is giving vision. Now you can go for two here. You can go all the way across here, get to this UAZ, or you can go all the way through here and catch this UAZ. Both are very good. Both will work just fine. Just getting a single UAZ kill at this point would be huge. And by UAZ, I mean command vehicle, because that is what they are. Speaking of which, highly effective location here on this PTR's Conquerors. Able to get two vehicles so far. Highly, highly good. And this place will continue to stalemate. This place, however, of course, is going to get its T-72, and this will begin the bleeding for WTF in space. WTF in space, of course. A little bit of a joke, I guess. This is the European ladder, of course, and I'm pretty sure most of these guys are from an area that knows of Angry Birds in the space. And yes, the T-72 right in the middle of town here will stop and the points will begin to stream in. Yes, it does. And this is going to put a pretty big crunch here on WTF. Now, of course, this is only a slow trickle. And this is why this map is chosen as the finals, because this map is, for all of its problems, is a balanced map. It's really hard to grab these middle bases. Absolutely hard. You have to invest a lot. And it's very easy for the other team to, in fact, come back. Very easy. They just push one side or the other and just smash through. Now, of course, this is currently not the side to smash through. Just too many conquerors in that location. And WTF is actually going to go ahead and try and grab this location here. And miss. Shame on you, rank 2 conquerors. They will be, yes, moving up a little more infantry here, trying to get these 4 base locations. And realistically, they should be able to move a command in here very soon. Now, one of the more fearful things about the current meta is that if you have too much space between, or not enough space between you and your enemy, they will just spot your command and ninja bomb a napalm or a cluster bomb or something along those lines. And we saw some sacrificial 60 PBs there to just kind of get an idea of what exactly is out there. It also evidently provided vision for these conquerors get at least one rocket off and able to kill 160 PB. Not entirely the best trade, but the information was no doubt worth it. Napalm going down again, getting the motor strokes again, and that kills roughly half his forward infantry forces. With support, the motor strokes will come in, but I don't know about this. They're kind of like running along fire here, and of course there's 2 missing, so they can't form the perfect circle formation as they run into the fire, and will be seeing some friendly fire damage here. Of course, this is generally speaking how friendly fire happens in war. You have one team who napalms his own men. Speaking of which, you are all, of course, being fielded forward. He wants these to get shot, wants them to be destroyed, and the idea here is to hopefully that they're invisible to the enemy and he'll just right-click on them. It's like, oh my god, why am I firing on that? But there's absolutely no bait being done here. There's no resources being destroyed here. With these Urals, anytime a unit fires, they are spotted. They also waste ammunition by killing them. And here's another Yak. What will he be shooting on? It looks like, oh, good location here. Actually gets Spetsnaz and MT-LV Strela. And we'll get the Spetsnaz. The Strela will get away, but at what cost? Looks like 1 hit point so far. And there goes the infantry. Pretty huge Yak attack right there. And look at this. The Modal Strokies mounting themselves up. Now, in the current metagame, a pretty common place for you to have a command is around here. And of course, PLF knows this. They're very aware of this. So they put their command in here, which is a very unexpected place. It's a very unique place, too, because it's almost completely secure. So these Modal Strokies are going to try and move up here, snipe the command, and move back. But little do they know, there isn't one there. Well, it looks like they'll have to settle for some AA instead. And of course, the Berusa has the autocannon. And the autocannon is insanely good against infantry. Not only does it stun, it also does insanely high amounts of damage, peeling down that single squad of infantry down to nothing in no time fast. Modal Strelkies looks like they'll be falling apart as well. T-72s from this flank coming in, and actually might be able to get a few shots off here. Targeting, unfortunately, the wrong thing here. Going for these really dug in 40 infantry. 2 T-72s go down, so suddenly the trades for WTF are not looking so good. BMPT will chase down this Modal Strelky, will go for a kill, and no, actually the Modal Strelky will pull back. This is just a little cool little cliff here that you can completely exploit, but in this case it looks like PLF were prepared. And speaking of which, remember cheapy Spetsnaz that we're talking about? Yeah, mission accomplished, people! He in fact was able to get this 2-point base, which is huge. So despite the fact that there was a big push up here and it was very, very successful, the fact that WTF was cheaping out so much on their defenses on these places that are outside of the flanks has cost them dearly. Looks like they're 2 points behind, and now we're seeing some pretty serious trickling here as PLF is moving further and further ahead. Now, as I said, the T-80U is the much favored command tank. Absolutely. Everyone loves this thing. It's much, much more armored. You're looking at, yes, 20 armor, the mother of all armor. And it can actually join in fights and be very effective. Looks like this 4 base will not fall just yet. There's a second T-80U here as well supporting. So this will be a little bit of a hiccup for a while. Now this single Spetsnaz here, of course, is going to stick around because if another command comes, he can kill it too. And there should be another command coming because they need this 2-point base. They absolutely do. They can't win without that 2-point base. And because they're not reinforcing it, it's absolutely possible that we might see a little bit of a push-up. This T-80A is trying to move around to a unique location so that it doesn't get sidestruck by this flank here of vehicles. And oh my god! Did you see that? Yes, a MiG just killed a T-80A. That was completely unexpected by me. And looks like the Rebetka was successful in spotting it. And that is brutal loss. Back to the drawing board here for Red, as they only need to deploy something a little more cost effective. Speaking of which, finally has that UAZ coming in here. We'll try and get that 2-point base. And we're in this kind of really awkward situation. There's PLF has a pretty massive lead right now. 150 points is getting close to a quarter of the way victory. We have 22 minutes left on the match. We're going to need to see a pretty decisive push here from WTF. They will need to abuse whatever they can. And the number of tanks here for PLF is actually shrinking, which is something you have to consider in all of this. Their tank count is shrinking. WTF sniped a T-80A. That was absolutely huge. And there's not really a lot of T-80s left on the map. There's one here, and I think it's just that one. That's the only T-80 left here on the map for Red. And in pack versus pack, the T-80 count is absolutely critical. Generally speaking, at the end, you can almost count the winner by who has more T-80s. Because when that big tank push comes, with that T-80s and those filler T-72s and maybe some T-64s and what, the T-80 is what does all the damage. Everything else is just filler, you know? So this is, and also the T-80 takes a lot of damage. If you try to get it down, they don't die so easily. So this is a possibility for WTF, but they have to do something soon. Now they will get the UAZ in here. Keep in mind, this UAZ was targeted close to this existing Spetsnaz, and this is basically an endgame scenario. If this Spetsnaz squad here is able to kill this command, that's game. It's absolutely game. Now, there's also coming a very brilliant command vehicle going to try and possibly get in right here and cancel it this zone. So that'll come in their favor. And let's see, 1 point every 3 seconds. We have 22 minutes left. That's 1,200 seconds divided by 3. That will give us 400 points. Absolutely, they can come back. This will work as long as they can hold it. So two things have to go for WTF. One, this Spetsnaz cannot kill this command. If that happens, they're in such trouble. They have nothing here defending, and the Spetsnaz is winding up. This could be huge. Oh my god! Fires! Get one hit point off, and the second one. Oh god, that is an endgame scenario right now. There are two anti-infantry vehicles coming, but the damage has been done. Now we call for a defense here from Hunter, as he wants to get this vehicle up. He wants to get a nice little smoke here. Here's the smoke. Now he's going to be able to move his command up perfectly timed. And here we go. The command will move up through the smoke into this jungle location and cancel off this point. These are the non-standard tactics. This is stuff that we're only seeing at the top level, that we're not seeing at the bottom level. And here comes a big payload. Will it hit the command? Only hits the infantry. That's pretty good. The command, in fact, pulled back. And more infantry will, in fact, move forward from the Red as they're going to jump this forest. And this plan is just falling apart very, very quickly. This is what they needed to do to win this, and it's just not working out. Now, if you're hearing helicopter noises, that's not helicopters in the game. That's real-life helicopters. I live in Newfoundland, and we are one of the biggest helicopter bases in North America. We just have constant helicopters, and I happen to live 10 minutes from an airport. The UAZ will get in, will click off. It's going to come down to this 2-point base. One, will they get rid of the Spetsnaz? That's pretty big. Two, how long will it take them for getting their command here? That's another big thing. Every single time you buy a command, and a command is minimum 100, maximum 280, it's going to cost you something. It could be a tank, it could be a fleet of tanks, it could be helicopters, it could be a napalm bomber, cluster bomber, a whole 100 infantry, lots of stuff. Now here's our sneaky motostrokis, which of course have been spotted. And remember, these motostrokis have a very specific role. They are to come up from the side flank, attack in, try and get the tank, and then run away. But of course, it's not going to work. Now we are finally going to get another command coming in here, and they have to kill the Spetsnaz, which has been very much evading, very, very much. And they know it's here because the Spetsnaz stole this U-Roll. This is not his, I assure you. And it looks like he's going to try and give it back because he's a good guy. Good guy, you roll, and yes, finally getting spotted here. Anti-infantry squad will fire. Weapons were turned off temporarily, because he didn't want to give away his position. And Spetsnaz, not so good, actually going to destroy both anti-infantry vehicles. Absolutely brutal. There's, look how desperate this is coming. Prizik Strela is coming in to join the fray. Not enough. A MiG actually being deployed to kill a single infantry squad and isn't able to target, looks like. There are two more 60 PBs, the BTR variant, coming in here trying to get the Spetsnaz. And this has just been the absolute most cost-effective Spetsnaz. It's killed two commands. It's killed two anti-infantry vehicles. It's seemingly going to kill a few more, and finally the big boys, the Motostrelkis, are in here, and another command vehicle will come in here. So we're looking at a point where all the commands of WTF have to survive, and keep in mind, this is a constant napalm zone. There's no forward AA here. There's nothing to really stop these yak attacks, as they are sometimes called, and he's going to have to fortify around this, and there's not a lot of Motostrelkis here, and the lack of infantry will be very problematic. Of course, there are still the very well-placed conquerors here, which can stop anything that comes in. Did get a miss on the T-64, but that is something else. Now, this forward ground here is very, very good. Very good. The jungle region has been mostly pretty tame. Usually, this is a little more exciting of an area, this jungle area, just because there's actually an imbalance in the map. It's these bases here. They end up being pretty imbalanced. You can, if you can get a unit in here, they can pick off almost anything that comes out. It's pretty brutal to deal with, and you have to be a pro to deal with, of course. Now when a Spetsnaz off, and when one Spetsnaz loses, you just call on your buddy the helicopter, and he'll finish this guy for you. Both Spetsnaz actually looking to escape this little standoff. One hit point left, actually, and dead, actually. Big victory for the Spetsnaz. Speaking of packed victory impending, we're looking at a relatively close game. Smoke being used here, of course, to stop these conquerors from firing, and there will be a follow-up artillery barrage as well. He wants to get this TO-55 across, and this is just good coordination. Smoke the area, get your stuff in, move your vehicles across. The TO-55, of course, on this map is absolutely critical. You need a flamethrower tank on this map just so you can clear out these town areas cost-effectively. Some people refer to them as zones. I call them towns. And because of just how many of these times the conquerors have been hit, there's actually a helicopter, an AT helicopter, being deployed here with good old-fashioned Sakalos. The TO-55 will get across, will move in, and should be able to rain some chaos and tyranny on that location. God, T-80U, such a crazy range on this. Now, once again, both teams doing roughly the same thing with the U-Rolls, and this is kind of like a semi-standard type of play. You put all the U-Rolls up front, and you hope that they fire on them. In destruction, this is kind of frowned upon, because unless you can fire back, you lose something, but there's no real loss here. You've used them all for what they're worth. TO-55 versus T-80U is not going to be a good engagement, by the way. Looks like the T-80U will, in fact, pick off this TO-55, and hope is ruined. UAZ is 3 points left. That is brutal. Now that's a backup UAZ. Keep in mind, this is something that's kind of new and very exciting in Conquest. The fact that UAZs are so cheap, but also so easily destroyed, people prefer to just buy a second one as a backup rather than get something a little tankier. And it's a different change. I mean, this, you have 100 points for those UAZs, and then when you look at the tank, 200. So it's about even, works at the same. It's just that the tank dies, he dead, and that's it. But one other big advantage to this, of course, is that if you have two UAZs and one goes unused, hypothetical situation, that means that when you actually push forward, you have a second UAZ. Now here comes some rain of chaos here. Double Yak going to try and fill this entire jungle with napalm. Will they hit the targets? Both Yaks will go down. This is completely suicide mechanics here. Motostrelki is hit. UAZ is completely in the clean, as it looks like the second attack didn't go off. Now, it looks like a fourth UAZ is going to come here. And a lot of these air attacks, these suicide attacks, are very common in Conquest and will stop the bleeding. but he needs to get another command somewhere. Actually, that will be the command he needs. Should give him a plus one, potentially. Now, of course, this B-tier 60PB did not expect this T-64 to be here. Doesn't matter. Apparently, he was running through fire and will die anyway. The 60PB will continue on through, though. Could actually go after this command. Even just stopping this command from capping is absolutely huge. If he can get through here, that would be amazing. And actually able to do it. So now we're looking at a situation that is almost unwinnable for the WTF in space. In fact, going to go for an early declaration here. Congratulations to the PLF clan on their first ESL victory. No unit, of course, were winners from last week. And talking to one of their guys, they said Lemieux could not make it. So it's all Lemieux's fault, and they should be back next week. Or the North American ladder, if it's possible. But this week, looks like PLF is going to have it. 12 minutes left on this game. I don't really see anything big happening. I say that every time, and then something big happens. It's like, I don't see anything big happening. And then there's like 40 modal strel keys supported by two T-80s pushing up. I mean, in order for WTF FTW to win this, they would need to move up here, clear Bravo, come up here, clear Charlie, and then move in here, clear Alpha. And the reason why that's what they would need to do is because they have two reinforced points, one, two, and this is the big base. So if they can clean out the reinforcing points, they won't be able to, and by they I mean, sorry, the PLF will not be able to field units. That, of course, is huge. And if they can't field units, they can of course attack relentlessly and destroy all commands. Now they have that's pretty far-fetched. You'll have to admit that's a pretty far-fetched way of going. They are doing a pretty successful motostrelky push here. Will it be enough? That's something else. The T-80s do need to engage. They do need to get up, and they basically need to clear this here. This is the idea: move your infantry up here, move your tanks up here. Have your tanks fire down this line. And you also need to get some infantry in here, unfortunately, to try and clear any potential AT. Now, since the T-80s are so armored, however, they can take a few shots. So that will cut out that reinforcement point pretty much altogether. Now, we do have some helicopters coming in. Helicoptered infantry, and not a ton of AA in the area, actually. So these helicoptered infantry, on top of giving infantry, could also do a little bit of damage on their own right. They don't really have a lot of ammunition. 128 rounds, 5x5 is not really that great. But they will be very, very effective at that. But like I said, it's really far-fetched right now for WTF in space to be able to take this. They've done very good, though. They've gotten to the finals, which is, you know, very impressive. They beat a lot of amazing competition to get here as well. It's not like they're just beating lightweights, they're beating a lot of the best in the game. And the same is true with PLF, of course. Next week, we'll be seeing another tournament. We'll see other players, which will be great. I'm very interested to see which BPT team wins the semi-final spin-off. I might do that game, depending on how busy I am this week. And, yeah. Kind of sad, actually, to see the WTF go just yet. It would have been nice to see a push to the finish. And here comes the T-80s, and this is the positioning we're talking about. Comes up with motostrelkies, moves in, guards this flank, and nothing can reinforce from here. Absolutely nothing. These T-80s will tear it apart. There are some T-80s coming up to support some motostrelkies against T-80A, and the T-80U, of course, is very superior. As it climbs up this mountain, it shouldn't actually be attacked by anything but the T-80A. Close range, the T-80A is like, I am getting out of here, and it pushes the off button. It's out of there. There's no reinforcements coming in. There's a lot of forces here. And here comes the helicopter I was talking about, doing a little bit of fire position command, able to strike lots of forces. But once again, look how fast this ammunition is gone. It will be only able to do one more barrage. TO-55 able to do a pretty awesome attack on these cavalry tanks, which are being stunned and forced back. Motostrelkies all dying, and this all-in is all they have. Here comes a cluster bomb as well. I mean, all the cards are in favor of PLF right now, one of the most coordinated splash defenses you'll ever see. TO-55s using flamethrowers. We have artillery firing stuns, and then we have cluster bombs destroying almost everything. We have 3-4 tanks left here, and a Motostoki squad. Here comes the last smash, and oh my god, everything's gone except there's a single cavalry tank, and this is it, people. PLF has completely squashed the last resistance here from the WTF clan. I wouldn't be surprised if they continue playing this out. One of the big problems between conquest and destruction is that you never really know how far you are behind until you see the replay afterwards. And Motostroki still able to push through a little bit, but it looks like not enough of the army surviving. That's a big, big part of this. When you do a big push like this, your army just has to completely crush, push on through, crush, push on through. Like, it has to be pretty brutal. And one of the nice things about this conquest mode that you didn't see in destruction is that when you're winning in destruction, like, a pretty common tactic is to, like, hide your commands because last minute stuff is pretty scary. But in conquest, of course, your commands are being protected by flanks everywhere. It's far less likely that they're going to just all in your commands. And as this last bit of Motostroki is getting cleaned out, VDV's trying to chase him down, get some last-minute kills. One squad escaping here from Skydrake. Ooh, absolutely brutal. I would be interested to see who wins on total kills here. I suspect it's also PLF that's doing that, just because these engagements have been pretty brutal. But if you look at the actual number of blue and red, like, it looks very blue, right? You know, it's really weird how that works out. And of course, here comes another cluster bomber. And since we're so close to the end of this, we're about 6 minutes left, you see a lot of people do a lot of silly things. And one good example of a silly thing is using a cluster bomb to kill a single UAZ, which has been spotted by this single VDV. Now they're going to move out here, spawn point out here, and then fire the round once they get a good angle. And the angle's good. They get the load off, and do they destroy? Will they destroy? Will they? They do, in fact, get it, and the bleeding continues. That has been one of the most brutal locations. The Tunguska, of course, completely left unprepared, had absolutely no supply trucks resupplying it. A little late to the race here, you all, 4320. Honest to God, you guys here are not the heroes today. You might be the heroes another day, but with your supremely black-tinted windows and jacked-up tires, you are not the heroes today. Yeah. PLF doing very well. And teams, of course, are doing really well in this tournament. So far, BPT, WTF, and PLF have all done very well in all the tournaments. No units, of course, they're one team. Didn't make it this time. Might make it next time. 5 minutes left over. There's nothing WTF in space can do right now. They kind of have been defeated. Yep. Looks like it's going to be the last minute artilleries. Yeah, there's a few. That's the big reason why you stay in. There's just a lot of last minute stuff that could, like, oh my god, if only that would happen. Like, if you were to already shell this area here, and it was a jeep instead of an armor, but looks like PLF went almost entirely for armors. These are, of course, a little more expensive, but they have one armor compared to the jeeps that have zero. And, yeah. No way in hell. Actually, PLF is going to rally an extra little command tank here. Or sorry, command armor. And trying a location. Here comes the last minute little hurrah once again. Skydrake going for. And this is what we call the raining man. Basically, you fly your helicopters over the target. They get destroyed. Or they destroy the command. One or the other. And if they get destroyed, infantry will rain on out. And will spot for some air attacks. And do some damage in their own right. And if they stay alive, they destroy it like they did. And it's an absolutely brutal technique. It's very effective. And I'm kind of hoping secretly, don't tell the community this, I hope it doesn't get nerfed. I actually like it. It's very neat. Speaking of which, that little snag there was enough to put a +2 for WTFIS. Once again, still not really enough. There is a command armor right here. And so once they clear these VDV squads, they should be mostly fine. In fact, oh, cluster bomb on location. How much will it actually kill? Ooh, none actually. Complete miss. But there are some vehicles here on the side. one down. I just can't see this. Oh my god, plus four. What is a plus four? How is that even possible? Dead here? Oh my god, now there is a command hover coming up here. They don't have this zone, of course, so it's plus four. I don't think that changes anything. I think it's really close, but I don't think it changes anything. This command will come in here, reestablish this reinforcement point, and, you know, business as usual, of course. I wouldn't be surprised if some players come down to just insta-kill this thing. But what is Bubba doing? He's not sitting it. Oh, he wants to get inside the town. It's the most secure possible location. Shazam! And now we're at only plus three. Once again, I don't think this is enough. I'm pretty sure. I'm doing the numbers in my head real quick, and this should put them at around 300. It will be close, but it shouldn't be enough for a win. And yes, plus one has changed hands. Look at this forward T80 UK here. Oh, Hunter, you and your forward T80 UK. This T72, by the way, has been there the entire game. And in fact, this plus two base here was wiped out, and that's the big reason why they're losing. A lot of these last-minute tactics can be effective, but I mean, if both players are doing last minute tactics, they kind of, you know, knock each other out. Nice little last minute valiant effort there by WTF. Of course, they have shown, and a lot of people are doing this. It's not really just an all-in. This is a nice, legitimate way of attacking, I think, and very successful here. Would have been much better earlier on if they were less desperate, and that's kind of the downside to these last minute desperation tactics, is that when it's all about the last minute, it's all about the desperation, you don't really have a lot of time to build up those points. And already this has been a much more successful game than last week. Last week, of course, was a complete stomp. No unit, just demolished. In this instance, looks like PLF want to protect their win, are rallying out commands left and right, and nothing but commands. There's only a minute left, and they can lose a million commands. That's absolutely possible. And they probably will lose a million commands. That's more likely, actually. And yeah, I think that'll probably be the last few commands they rally. It lost two commands to a single helicopter. Not very good. And a lot of bases looking very white. The two 2-point bases are both white, and that's unusual. You think one person would rally a vehicle and put them in there, and MiG's gonna come in here and try and clean up the shop of that helicopter, and we'll mostly escape. Looks like you're trying to swing around and get some more MiG action here. Of course, it is beautiful to watch them work. Ooh, so beautiful. 27 seconds left. Once again, PLF victory. Congratulations, PLF, WTF in space. Better luck next time. Love to see you in the finals once again. Pretty balanced, even match. And it's all been pretty random. I'd be very interested to see who could possibly win this next week. So far, we've had four different teams in the finals, and that is phenomenal for competition. Best of luck, guys. Keep up the good work, and practice. My name is Trollmaker. It looks like the kills, in fact, went to PLF. Join me next week when I'll be doing another match from the finals. See you guys then.